Hi Aries, welcome to my channel. This is the full month of January 2021 love and general situationship reading for you Aries. I hope you are well. I hope you're fine. I hope you're safe wherever you are right now. This reading is for you. Thank you so much Aries for being here. Thanks for subscribing. Thanks for liking. Thanks for supporting my channel. Guest viewers, if you haven't, click the subscribe button and the bell. Please do it now if you're interested and if you are keen. And if you would like to further support my channel, check out the description box below. Ooh, ouch. Three of Swords. And connect with me via Instagram. Check out my online store. The products, they're free shipping. It comes with a free reading and free manifestation reading for me. Type your question, type your manifestation, and I will get back to you. The daily collective reading over the next 24 hours, it is already available. It is in the website. So check the link. It's down the description box below. Okay? So this is for the full month of January 2021. This is for Aries. I will be delivering love intuitive message, career and finance, and general situationship for you. This is a full month reading for you. So let's start your reading. Let's start with love, intuitive message. You've got Three of Swords. Wow. Heartbreak, break up, in pain. For some of you, you are making yourself upset. Pain management. I'm really getting a vibe that don't make yourself further angry. Like, you're upset and you're aggravating the pain or the anger furthermore if you do this. There's something triggering you. The card flip. Could be a third party. It could be a heavy betrayal. It could be a breakup. But it is preventing you to move on. Okay? Three of Swords, the Tower card in the Tower card in reverse. Something heavy is preventing you to heal, to forgive, to move on. It's not good for you, most especially if it's the new year. It's time to really shake off the baggage. Because the Seven of Swords is in reverse, the Knight of Pentacles in reverse. It's telling you, okay, this is very direct in terms of love and romantic. It's telling you, Aries, whoever that person is that betrayed you, that's not your person. It's not your person. It's not someone who meant to stay in this specific period. It is a missed opportunity. If that person stayed in your life, okay, you've got a knight, but they will cheat and cheat and betray you, okay? So it was taken away from you, this person, okay? It was a knight. It was amazing. It feels great to be with this person, but there was a third party. There was pain, okay? It is a missed opportunity. This reading, this love intuitive message for you, Aries, it's telling you to move on. It's telling you to accept that this is a missed opportunity, a missed alignment. This is a person who is in disguise. You thought they were the one, but they aren't, okay? It's a missed opportunity. It was meant to be put in place in your life to correct something. Seven of Swords in reverse. There's something beautiful that will happen for you out there. There's something up for grabs for you out there in 2021. But it's preventing, it is difficult to kick off. Like, it's difficult. It's, you know, it's not starting. And something great and beautiful and amazing is here for you in 2021. But it's starting, it is difficult to propel. You know, it's having difficulty to start the engine of your 2021 because of this baggage. You're still sitting in something very old, something rusty. Something that doesn't give you a good fire. You know, your good flame needs to be ignited. This is not your person. There is a message here for you, Aries. Accept that this is a defeat and there's a blessing in disguise. This is a missed opportunity. This isn't your person, because if that's your person, they won't do this. Three of Swords, okay? So that was heavy to start off for you, Aries. The second reading, this is career, finances, project. Six of Cups in reverse, the Five of Wands. You're afraid. You're kind of playing safe into something. You want to start a new career, a new venture, a new project, a something that would give value into your life, but you're hesitating to do it. You could still be in vacation mode because I really feel like you could not make up your mind. Five of Wands, Six of Cups, Two of Pentacles. I mean, in essence, for example, you want to lose weight. It's in your mind, but you're not putting an action or you're not pushing yourself to the limit on, you know, on losing weight for some of you. If it's a project, if it's a career, if it's a finance, if it's a business, if it's applying for a job, the concept, all right, the concept of that is there. It is strong. You're playing with the concept, but you haven't really locked it in. Okay, the concept is there. You really need to lock in your intuition, your mind, your heart, and your fire into this project, career, something that will add value and confidence into your life. You need to lock it in, okay? You need to concentrate and really pull yourself together into... You have a concept. You have an idea. It needs the flame, the fire, the effort, the whole ingredients to allow this to happen. Like, concentrate. Give yourself a day to wonder and ponder and inspire. Look at that, the High Priestess. High Priestess, inspire. Okay? I'll put it in upright position. Let's lock it in. And then the last reading, this is random, whatever I could pick up randomly for you. Eight of Swords. A lot of indecision making. You could be waiting for friends or family or acquaintances or career about a decision making. And it's about money, Nine of Pentacles. For some of you, you're moving into, you're finding house or something to rent, a space. You couldn't do it on your own. There's a decision making about a house, a career, a rent, something that you're tied up. You can't do it alone yourself. You need to have a partner. So if it's, for example, you would like to have this apartment, you can't lease it on your own. You have to have tenants. So there's something of that. You would like to have freedom, this Nine of Pentacles. Right now, it's quite complicated. Whatever you're aiming in the next 2 to 3 weeks, it's something that you cannot do it alone for the moment. You need help. You need support. And you got to accept that. It will gradually be okay. I'm hearing the word, you can stand alone. But right now, this is a moment where you have to accept. You need help. You need support. If this is, for example, I'm really getting like a property or, I don't know, lease. I mean, the house is great, but it's expensive if it's just you. So you have to get someone to lease it along with you. You got to team up. There's something in here that you need to be collaborative. You cannot stand alone right now. It's the moment, this now, this Nine of Pentacles. You will achieve this, not now. Like, pretty much around the month of March, I'm getting like you could be this Nine of Pentacles. But right now, you need to be collaborative. You need to be a team player. You need someone's support, okay? You're no man's island. And what else? You've got the Death card in reverse, the Wheel of Fortune. Yep. It's just the wrong timing. You wanted to be independent, but you can't. And it's making you feel, I don't know, upset, disappointed because you really want to have it all, but it's the timing is quite off. It's like break even if you try to push this decision making or try to do it alone. You might be shortened with you might encounter difficulty. Okay, so accept help. Okay, accept help. Be collaborative. Be expressive of you need help. You it's better to do it in a group. That's what I'm getting from here. Okay, So this is you. This is your full month of January 2021. Thank you so much for tuning in. Thanks for being here. I hope you liked the reading. If you do, don't forget to hit the subscribe button and the bell. And I'll see you soon again, guys. And happy, happy new year. Bye-bye.